गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन. आर नेक्स्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर टू इज टू फाइंड आउट द इफेक्ट ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स ऑन द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन बिटवीन सोडियम थायोसल्फेट एंड हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड. नाउ लेट अस सी द थियरी ऑन विच दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इज बेस्ड. द थियरी इज इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन. As you all know, children, suppose A and B are the reactants reacting together to give you the product B, AB. The rate of reaction is equal to K into molar concentrations of A and B. Rate of reaction, as you all know, it is directly proportional to the product of molar concentration. Now, children, here we are taking sodium thiosulfate and hydrochloric acid. This is a reaction we are going to do, children. Sodium thiosulfate reacts with hydrochloric acid to form sodium chloride, sulfur dioxide, water and sulfur. This is the colloidal sulfur which we will see the speed of formation of the colloidal sulfur is what we will determine here. That will show you the rate of reaction. These are the volumes of sodium thiosulfate, distilled water, and 5 ml of HCl has to be added in it. These are 5 sets of beakers in which we have taken the volume sodium thiosulfate solution of different concentration. As you can see the table 50, this consists of just 50 ml of sodium thiosulfate. This one consists of the second number beaker consists of 40 ml of sodium thiosulfate and 10 ml of distilled water. Third one consists of 30 ml of sodium thiosulfate and 20 ml of distilled water. Fourth one consists of 20 ml of sodium thiosulfate and 30 ml of distilled water. The last one contains 10 ml of sodium thiosulfate and 40 ml of distilled water. So you can see the concentration of sodium thiosulfate we have taken from this is of highest concentration, and the fifth one has the lowest concentration or the most dilute of sodium thiosulfate solution. Now we will be adding 55 ml of hydrochloric acid to each of these and record the time. Swati teacher will be helping me to record the time, children. Children, we have prepared 5 sets of beaker and we had put the cross underneath it. We have drawn, see, we have put cross underneath it. The colloidal sulfur, white colored, which is formed, it will be disappearing as we put hydrochloric acid. Okay. Now you can see we will start the time at zero. See, we'll put and stir a little bit. You will see that the cross will disappear. We will note down the time. See, the cross has disappeared. We had recorded the time that it is 27 seconds. Clear? Now, similarly, in the other one, we will be adding and noting down the time. Because this is a dilute one, it will take more time to disappear. You can see, children, the cross is disappearing and we had recorded the time as 36 seconds. In this way, as the concentration of the different beakers, sodium thiosulfate, decreases, the cross takes large time to disappear. That means the reaction will take at a slower speed with decrease in concentration of the sodium thiosulfate solution. The last fifth beaker, which consists of least amount of sodium thiosulfate, that is 10 milliliters of sodium thiosulfate and 40 milliliters of water, will take long time for the cross to disappear. So you can see here we can prove that rate of reaction of this experiment will decrease with the concentration of the reactant, that is sodium thiosulfate. Okay, and we will be plotting a graph taking the volume of sodium thiosulfate in the y-axis and 1 by time in the x-axis. See, we will record the time in this way and taking the inverse of time in this way. We will plot a graph which will be giving you a straight line graph, as you can see, like this. If we plot a graph by taking volume of sodium thiosulfate solution in the y-axis and time against x-axis, then it will be this type of graph. Thank you, children. So this is the experiment regarding chemical kinetics.